Innovation has always played a huge role in Toyota's success, ensuring they are market leaders in both hybrid electric and hydrogen fuel cell vehicles. The Prius range had sold over 6 million units as of January 2017. A blueprint for the principles and philosophies used by Toyota was first published in The Toyota Way 2001. This focuses on two key areas: continuous development and respect for people. These concepts from The Toyota Way, alongside the ideology of marginal gains, has been widely used as a managerial tool by many companies across the world in various industries. It is what inspired Dave Brailsford to develop the aggregation of marginal gains model at British Cycling. By making small or even minute improvements in different areas, you can make a big overall gain. The process starts with looking at events and riders in great detail. The events are broken down into their key components and analysed. The next step examines what it would take to be the best in the world in each of those components. British Cycling are only interested in medals. In performance-based sport, medals mean funding. Only the best will do. Inevitably, the decisions to work with certain individuals and not others can be ruthless. Let's look at one of my events, the Tandem Kilo. As I've mentioned, it's a race against the clock and four laps of the track. If we break the event into its key components, you can see a natural split into the four laps. But this is nowhere near specific enough. We need to delve much deeper. For instance, at the start of the race, a countdown clock counts you in. The starting gate is triggered to release the bike the instant the clock hits zero. Electronic timing systems allow us to calculate the time between the gate releasing and the point that the bike starts moving. Essentially, it's the reaction time. The ideal scenario is to get as close to zero as possible. Many riders may lose 2 to 3 tenths of a second here. This can be the difference between winning and losing. Despite the race taking about 60 seconds, saving a couple of tenths of a second before you even start pedaling is huge. This split second is just one of several key components in this event. Once we identify all the components of the race, we look at what the best in the world are doing, whether we can match this, and how we go about doing it. Going back to the previous example, looking solely at reaction time, there are several ways to improve it. Although different clocks are used at different events, they are all calibrated so that a second lasts as long as it should, exactly 1 second. Therefore, you realise that it's not about reaction time at all. It's simply going at the exact time you know the starting gate releases you. Repetition, visualization techniques, refining your rhythm are all ways of improving. By syncing your breath to the sound of the beeps in the last 5 seconds of the countdown, you can improve your rhythm, ensuring you burst out of the starting gate at the strike of zero.